Diandra. Diandra, what are you going to do?
I'm going presentation, ma'am.
Oh, you are going to present. Yeah. The topic is about what?
About insomnia.
Okay, come on. You can start from now on.
Now, ma'am.
Yeah, you greet your friend, mention your name, tell what you are going to do. Okay.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning, Ma'am Lin. Good morning, my friends. Today, I'm going to present about insomnia. First, I want to introduce myself. My name is Rafifa Sediandra, absent 28. Okay, first, I want to tell you, what is insomnia? Insomnia is a sleep problem because insomnia is a condition when a person has difficulty sleeping. This sleep disorder makes you not have the sleep time your body needs. And then there are symptoms of insomnia. First, difficulty falling asleep or having trouble sleeping well. Number two, feel tired when you wake up and don't feel refreshed. When you wake up, feeling discouraged. Number three, trouble concentrating. Cannot do activity properly the next day. And the last, easy to get angry. Easy to feel tired and emotional. Next, there are causes of insomnia. First, stress or restless because of thinking of problem being experienced. Number two, lack of exercise. The body is brought into motion. Number three, poor diet. Eating fibrous food before going to bed can make it difficult to sleep well. Number four, depression. Want to get away from the problem. Number five, effect drug side. Treatment or a disease can sometimes cause insomnia. And the last one, influence of caffeine, nicotine, and alcohol. Caffeine and nicotine are stimulants. Meanwhile, alcohol disrupts sleep patterns. Next, there are impact of insomnia. First, it is easier to suffer from depression due to difficulty sleeping to become depressed. Number two, lack of sleep can cause ailments, including heart disease. Number three, can be drowsy or overslept during the day. Can threaten work safety, including driving vehicles. Number four, lose a lot of work time, reduce the ability to fulfill daily tasks and enjoy less life activity. And the last, I want to tell how to overcome insomnia. First, you can do regular exercise. I recommended that you do it at least 4 hours before going to the bed. And next, avoid caffeine, nicotine, and alcohol, especially in the afternoon and evening, because caffeine, nicotine, and alcohol, it's not good for your body. And last one, you can do meditation or relaxation, exercise stress relief techniques. That's all my explanation. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Diandra. Okay, guys. Question related to the topic about insomnia. Come on, you will get extra point by answering. Yeah, Kira. Yeah, what is it?
I want to ask, is there any ways to deal with insomnia or do you need to go to the doctor?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, what do you think, Diandra?
There is no need to go to doctor, mm-hmm. But we can adopt a healthy lifestyle. If necessary, it's okay to go to the nearest doctor.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there any other question?
Me, ma'am.
Okay, Lika, what is it?
Diandra, example of good exercise to treat insomnia.
Oh. Yeah. What should you do?
If we want to overcome insomnia with exercise, mm-hmm. we can do light exercise. Mm-hmm. Example is yoga or jogging or aerobics.
Okay. Is there any other question? about insomnia. Okay, thank you, Kira. Thank you, Lika. Well done, Diandra.
Thank you, Diandra.
Okay, next, please. For the next performance, please welcome Dafa Rahman. Dafa, what are you going to do?
Okay, Dafa? My name is Dafa Rahman Hakim. Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, friends. Today, I will tell story. The title is The Judge Monkey.
The story, yeah, okay. Okay, guys, listen to the story. You will find out what is the moral of the story. Okay, Dafa, you can start now.
Once upon a time, two cats were passing through the street. Suddenly, they spotted a loaf of bread lying beneath a tree. Both pounced upon it and caught the loaf at the same time. "It's mine. I saw it first," claimed one cat, while the other said, "I pounced upon it first and saw it belongs to me." After having fought for a while, one cat said, "Let us divide it into two and take one piece each." "Indeed a good idea," said the other cat. "But how do we divide it now?" A monkey sitting on the branch of the tree had watched all that happened between the two cats. "The loaf of bread looks good. I could do it myself," he thought. Slowly he came down from the tree and walked up to the confused cats. "Yes, my dear friends, can I help you?" asked the monkey. The cats thought what the problem was and said, "Why do not you be the judge between us?" When the monkey nodded, the cat said, "Please divide this loaf for us." The clever monkey smilingly broke the bread into two pieces, but one piece was a little bigger than the other. "Oh no, I will take a little bite of this bigger piece to make both equal," said the monkey slyly. He took a bite from the bigger piece, but he had taken a big bite. "Oh no, it has become smaller than the other piece. I will just have to take a little bite from this piece now," said the clever monkey. The judge monkey took another bite, and the two cats sat in from the monkey, seeing the loaf of bread they had found getting smaller and smaller. When the whole loaf was eaten by the monkey said, "I'm sorry, my dear friend, I was really difficult to divide that loaf. I must be going now." And the monkey jumped onto the tree and was gone. If only we had not argued among ourselves, we would have remained united and we need not have to go to the monkey and to become hungry now, said the two cats. Okay, done, ma'am.
Okay, yeah. Guys, can you find out what is the moral of the story? Yeah. Shekinah, come on, Shekinah.
If you keep fighting among yourself, a third person will always take away your opportunity, like the monkey in the story.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, guys, anyone? Is there any other opinion? What is the moral of the story? Anyone? Okay, thank you, Shekinah. Thank you, Dafa. Applause.
Amen.
Next performance. Please welcome Jawad. Jawad, what you gonna do?
Yes, ma'am. Mm-hmm. I will be speech.
Come on, show your face.
Yes, wait, ma'am, wait, ma'am. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Let us offer thanks for the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mm-hmm. Because of His mercy, we can get in this room, room in good health. On this special occasion, allow me to say a word to about the importance of protecting myself from the danger of drugs. Mm-hmm. With the rapid advancement of technology, It is not unusual for information development to make it easier for us to get something. No, we don't have to bother to get things even though it is constrained by location difference. Therefore, is it only natural or kept remote jobs? At present, of drug trafficking are increasingly alarming. The main target of drug trafficking is no longer adults, but children. Therefore, is it only natural that we also supervise and provide education about the importance of protecting ourselves from the danger of drugs? The easy way to socialize the danger of drugs is to provide education at the family level. The role of the parents and close people is very important. Knowledge of various types of drugs and their effects must be conveyed to prevent the spread of drugs more widely. There are so many speech about drugs that I can convey. If there are mistakes in word and sentence when conveying, please apologize me. Thank you.
Okay, yeah. The topic is about the danger of drugs. Yeah, so anyone? Question related to the topic, the dangers of drugs. Anyone? Extra point. Come on. Okay, well, lucky you, Jawa. There is no question for you. Okay, applause for Jawa.
Yes, thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, next performance. Please welcome Sharif Muhammad Jawad. Sharif, what are you going to do?
I'm going to story about the movie.
Movie review. What movie?
Not movie review, ma'am. Actually, I'm gonna tell the story. All of the story.
Oh, based on the movie?
Yes.
Okay.
So, good morning, everyone. My name is Sharif Muhammad Jawad, absent before. Today, I want to tell a story of the movie named Pirates of the Caribbean, The Curse of the Black Pearl. It's the first installment of the Pirates of Caribbean franchise. It released in 2003, starring Johnny Depp, Geoffrey Rush, Orlando Bloom, and Keira Knightley. The film was inspired by partly based on the Pirates of the Caribbean attraction on Disneyland. So, at the beginning of movie, Governor Spahn is the new governor of Port Royal, England, and his young daughter Elizabeth Turner sail from England to the Caribbean on the boat. On the boat, the HMS Dauntless, a young officer, Lieutenant Norrington of the British Royal Navy, is also aboard. They come upon shipwreck with a sole survivor, a boy named Will Turner. Elizabeth discovered a gold school medallion around Will's neck and fearing that he will be executed as a pirate. Quickly, Elizabeth hides it from the others and Elizabeth briefly glimpses another ship with shredded black sails vanishing into the mist. 8 years later, Captain Norrington is being promoted to Commodore. Elizabeth attends the ceremony at her father's request. Jack Sparrow only just arrived in Port Royal, rescued Elizabeth from drowning. The skull medallion Elizabeth wearing around her neck emits a mysterious pulse through the water as he is sinking to the sea. That night, Port Royal is attacked by the infamous ghost ship known as the Black Pearl, a black sailed vessel crewed by vicious, bloodthirsty pirate, and captained by a man reputed to be so evil that hell itself spat him back out. Serious pulse that emanated from Elizabeth's medallion has called the Black Pearl. The pirates ransacked Port Royal and kidnapped Elizabeth as Barbossa showcased his attack on Port Royal in his exchange. The next day, Will Turner fails in his passionate effort to convince Commodore Norrington and the Royal Navy to immediately pursue the culprit because the Black Pearl's crew is kidnapping Will Turner. Elizabeth, I mean. And then Will is free Jack from jail and ask him to do the adventure together, saving Elizabeth. To let the crew discover that course was indeed real. However, still, even one of the coin shall be incapable of digesting food, experience what sense of touch conveys living or dying. They are therefore neither dead or alive. Only the bootstrap Bill or the father of Will or one or of his family is pelted on the gold will this curse be lifted. In the meantime, anyone under it roots deadly to be revealed moonlight as a mobile skeleton and little else. Due to Elizabeth attempt to discover her rank by using Will username, so he changed her name into Elizabeth Turner, Will last name. The pirates believe she is bootstrap doctor and use her accordingly poisoned over the chest of the gold. Barbossa makes a cut on her hand and lets blood it flow. There's no change. Just after the perk crew is unsuccessfully to leave course, Will and Elizabeth escape a boat after sabotaging the other and leaving Jack behind in keeping pirate's code, which say any man who fell behind left is behind. When Barbossa and the crew discover there is Jack on the island and Elizabeth and Will has escaped, they all want to kill Jack, but Jack gave the offer to the crew and Captain Barbossa that Jack can give Elizabeth and Will location. Back at Port Royal, Norrington prepares to hang Jack on Perslow, but Will, who believe in decent enactment not to deserve death, rescues Jack. Elizabeth, inspired by Will's sudden defense, as well as his confession to her, declines to marry to Norrington and declares her feeling for Will instead. Norrington agrees to release her from her promise and is pardoned for his criminal. Meanwhile, Jack escapes and awkwardly falls into the ocean to be rescued by his crew, which now he is the captain of the new Black Pearl. Norrington watches Jack's sails for unknown adventure, impressed by the pirate's knock to allow him one day head start before setting out on its pursuit. In a final scan on Isla de Muerte, Barbossa and the crew climb up from the water into Aztec chest, where he takes piece of treasure, Jack's skin, slope off, and the now the course crew strike ahead for a moment before punching forward, the skin disappearing his mouth. This is explain why Jack is still courts in the second movie and the third. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.
Applause. Yeah. Guys, question related to the movie The Pirates of Caribbean. Anyone else? What is the moral of the movie? Do you know what it's all about? The Pirates of Caribbean? Guys, extra point. social one. Okay, if you don't have question, okay, applause for Jawad. Next performance, please welcome Calvin Meiru. Calvin, what are you going to do?
Hello, ma'am.
Yeah? Calvin, you are going to?
Hello?
Yeah? Putus-putus, Calvin.
Putus, ma'am. It's better?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's talk a little more. Okay, once upon a time.
Yeah.
There was a mouse. I'm sorry. And mother mouse. They live in a hole in the big warm house with lots of cheese to it. Then, one day, Mother Mouse decided to take Baby Mouse outside of their home. But in outside, there was a hugginger tomcat. The tomcat licking its lips and waiting to eat them both up. The tomcat is saying in their heart like, oh man. Baby Mouse, mother, we do so scared, mother. The mouse staring into the eyes of the house. The mouse, she wasn't scared because she know exactly how to deal with big scary cats. So the mother mouse do like she open her mouth and took in a deep breath. The mother mouse said like this, she shouted, and the cat, because of that, the cat ran away as fast as he could. Wow, mother, that was amazing. Baby Mouse said to his mother, smiling happy. And that, my child, is why it is always best to have a second language. Hello?
Yeah.
Halo.
Baju. Oh.
Ini sih. Hey, Rip.
Calvin, are you done?
Yes. Yes, I'm done, ma'am.
The story about the mouse and?
And a ginger cat. Tomcat.
Tomcat. Yes. Okay. Yeah. Anyone knows what is the moral of the story? Okay, Calvin, can you share us what is the moral of the story, Calvin?
The moral is it's better to have a second language. It's like if we learn English, we know world word. So it's better to have a second language.
Okay, applause for Calvin. Thank you. Next performance.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, welcome. Please welcome Chiyo. Come on, Chiyo. Chiyo, are you here? Okay, what are you going to do, Chiyo?
Speech, ma'am.
Okay, speech. Come on.
On cam, ma'am.
Ya dong. Mau dapat nilai gak? Ya, yeah, come on, Cio. You greet your friend.
Assalamualaikum.
Guys. Yeah. Assalamualaikum.
Ladies and gentlemen. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
First of all, I want to say thank you so much to our teacher, Miss Lina, who has given me an opportunity to stand in front of you all and to deliver a speech about culture. All of us have our own culture, and regions also have unique culture. All nations have local genius culture too. If we are speaking about Indonesian culture, then we are talking about cultural diversity. In our country, if we want to condemn, then there will be hundreds of tribes, each of which has different culture. They have their own pattern of clothing, language, and teaching. It is obvious that in any culture aspect. Unfortunately, a recent survey showed that some of culture aspect become extinct. If that condition keeps on happening, that generously or original culture will disappear and are replaced with foreign one. My friends, we are now living in the midst of a dynamic life that continues to follow the development of the world. So it seems that the case as a result, we are unaware or have no effort to defend our own culture. If such condition is allowed to continue, it will end up our own culture. It can be seen that the mental younger generation now is so easy, it is receiving foreign culture. So sometimes that culture is not in line with the values of our own culture. So that is what I want to present in this short speech. We should prevent our high-valued culture from extinction. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Guys, the topic is about culture. Yeah, we have to save our culture so it won't be extinct. Yeah. Okay. Anyone? Any question related to the topic about culture? Extra point? Okay, I will recap first, yeah, for your points. Aifa, 2 points. And then Kira and Shekina, 3 points. Alif, Karen, Evelyn, Gaby, Kanaya, Sela, Lika, Melita, Najma, Dustin, Melati, Diandra, Safira, and Widat, 1 point. Come on. You have to collect as many as possible for the points. Come on. Anyone? Any question related to the topic about culture? Okay. Chio, thank you. Applause for Chio. Next performance. Please welcome Fauzan Martiza. Come on, Ojan. What are you going to do, Ojan?
I'm going to do a presentation.
Okay, Fauzan, presentation. The topic is?
Importance of sleep.
Wow, the important. Guys, listen carefully to the topic because you are going to ask question, yeah? So you will get the point.
Good morning, everyone. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi.
Good morning, Emily. Good morning, everyone. Today I'm gonna present about the importance of sleep. First of all, I'm gonna define what is sleep. Sleep, a condition of body and mind that typically occurs for several hours every night, in which the nervous system is relatively inactive, the eyes closed, the postural muscles relaxed and consciousness practically suspended. That's the scientific way, but in the simple way, we call it rest. From resting, we get the benefit of sleep. Since we are student, this is the benefit of sleep that can we take. First, sleep can improve your memory. Sleep helps reduce stress, and sleep puts you in a better mood. Why this is important for student? Because these three help us in the way of studying. And next is the CDC recommended amount of sleep for us is 13 to 18 years, so it's 8 to 10 hours sleeps per day. If you don't get this much of sleeps, you get sleep deprivation. What is sleep deprivation? Sleep deprivation is a condition of not having sufficient duration and or quality of sleep. It means we don't have enough sleep time. Lack of sleep can limit the ability to pay attention, react quickly, and make decision. And also, it has the long term. Having too little sleep may increase the risk of hypertension, diabetes, sleep apnea, obesity, heart attack, stroke, depression, and psychosis. Now, sleep deprivation can be treated by these steps. First of all, fixing your sleep schedule. Next, healthy lifestyle and taking medication if it turns seriously. That's all for me. Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. Guys, a question related to the importance of sleep. Come on, anyone? Malati, come on, Malati.
Do you have any tips to make us easier for sleep?
Okay, do you have tips to sleep early?
So first of all, if it's my own tip. So before you, if you want to sleep early, you can do like watching movies, mm-hmm, and read books that you think it's boring. So the more you get into the movie, the more you want to sleep, right? So sometimes I sleep with the movie still going, then when I wake up, it's already finished. So you can do that, or if you want to sleep early, stop anything what you do, and then sleep right away. Because scientifically, researchers says that if you don't do anything in 15 minutes and only sleeps on your bed doing nothing, you will automatically fall asleep.
Okay. Yeah. Any other question? Alif, what is it, Alif?
What advice do you have for people with sleep deprivation? Because I have a pretty bad sleep deprivation.
Like I said before, there's a treatment for sleep deprivation.
Okay.
Like first, fixing your sleep schedules, right? Like already said my tips or the scientific way to fall asleep faster. You can do that as well, or can change your healthy lifestyle. Like if you said that you have a bad sleep deprivation, if you have serious sleep deprivation, you can take medication from the doctors.
Thank you.
Is there any other question, guys? Okay, thank you. Anyone? Grace, what is it?
Yes, you can. If you don't have enough sleep at night time, you can change it to a quick nap in the afternoon or noon, like 2 hours or 3 hours.
Change the time to sleep. Okay, thank you, Ali, Malati, and Grace. Also, Ojan. Applause. Okay, Before we come to the next performance, all of you please on cam, because yeah, Lika will take the screenshot. Yeah, show your face, give your smile, you will get also extra point. Yeah, Jawad, smile, not green. Yeah, Lika, are you ready? Tell us who hasn't opened their camera. The same.
Mati, Kasih, Pak, Kira, Angel, Karen, Evelyn, Gaby.
Come on. Just by show your beautiful and handsome faces, you give your smile, yeah, you will get the point. Come on. Smile, yeah, guys. Today is the last day for the performance, yeah.
Mem, kayaknya jaringan saya ini gimana?
Kenapa nggak bagus ya?
Iya. Yang lain? Yang lain,
yang lain, guys, ada yang pakai laptop?
Aku, mem.
Oke, Kira. Come on, Kira. Smile, smile, guys. Social one.
1, 2, 3. Udah, ma'am.
Okay, don't forget to send the picture ya, Kira. Okay, my dear social one, we are going to continue the speaking practical test. So for the next performance, please welcome Faisal Hidayat. Icha, what are you going to do?
Presentation, ma'am.
Ya, come on.
Sebelumnya udah nyoba buat laptop saya share screen, kan laptop saya nggak bisa share screen, jadi saya minta tolong Kanaya, nggak apa-apa ya, Mem?
Oh, no problem. Come on.
Ya, ya, Kanaya lagi bikin, Mem. Sebentar. Sebentar ya, Mem.
Nah, ada okay. Ini.
Ah, sorry.
Ical, you want to skip first?
Wah, boleh deh, Mem.
Okay, ya. Yeah. Because Ical still preparing for the presentation. So, Sudirman, you are going to...
Hadir, Mem.
Yeah, Sudirman, what are you going to do?
Presentasi, Mem.
Okay, the topic is?
The art of planning in aquarium, Mem.
Okay, come on. Man,
yang share screen, Evander.
Okay, Evander, please... share.
Oke.
Okay. Ya. Yeah.
Oke, okay. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Hello everyone. I will the presentation art of the planning in aquarium. My name is Sudirman. My option is 33. Next. history. Aquascape history is the divided three, namely the ancient, medieval, and modern. Next. The ancient era. Aquascape history in the 1369, a Chinese imperial got the idea to make a container from the rising ornament the fish. The basic material is porcelain in the form of the bow as the container from the mounting ornament the fish. Next. In the Middle East, three were many new discover. One of the which was the discover of the three, the aquarium by several people like Dr. Nathaniel, Mr. Felix, Miss Annie, and by Mr. Robert. Dr. Nathaniel created the box of the glass as container from the mounting of the tropical animals and plant. Name the box is Guardian Box. Mm-hmm. In the 1838, Mr. Felix Guardian is nothing to have the great aquarium or seawater aquarium. Mm-hmm. And then perfect by Miss Annie, hit the aquarium and was able to form a seawater ecosystem so that seawater was able to keep coral and seaweed alive in Guardian case from the 3 years. And the last, Mr. Robert create the freshwater aquarium ecosystem or aquascape with a large about 13 gallon box filled with golden fish. Next. And modern. In the Victoria era, the aquarium design was a box width of the side of the wall made of the glass. The another side of the wall is made of the wood with is made waterproof. The bottom side is the made of the stone and is worn from below. The another design was introduced the use glass on all side of the wall and base. While the frame was made of the metal. Next. This the Takashi Amano who introduced aquascape in 1990. He is the aquarist and the first to make his the aquascape art of the famous in the world. His the work have the inspiration all aquarium lover in the world. His the making his the aquascape Takashi Amano implement the scenery and natural beautiful in Japan. Next. That what plants can be planted in aquascape. Next. Many from the plant in aquascape, Japan moss, water wisteria, next, Amazon sword, Anubias nana, next, draw baby and Java frame, next. Okay, this the example of the aquascape. The aquascape is the one object because the only display one object the aquarium. Okay, next. So that is from me. Thank you from listening my presentasi. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Yeah, guys, any question related to the art planting of the aquarium? Come on. Question. Yeah.
Me, ma'am.
Kanaya. Come on, Kanaya. The art of planting in an aquarium. Come on, guys. What is the question? Yeah?
Safira.
Oh, Safira. Yeah, Safira, what is the question?
Do the plant used in the aquascape have to according to the type of the fish?
Mm-hmm. Is there any correlation between the plant and the fish?
Ma'am, suaranya kurang kedengeran, ma'am.
Repeat once again, Safira.
Do the plant used in the aquascape based on the type of the fish?
Mm-hmm. Mem, boleh minta waktu bentar gak, Mem?
Okay. Is there any other question?
Me, Mem.
Okay. Calvin, what is it?
In a aquascape, all kind of fish can live in a aquascape.
What kind of fish can live in aquascape? Yes. Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Okay, so you are going to find the answer for Calvin and Safira, yeah? You need time, Sudirman?
Okay.
Okay.
I the job to Safira. The Safira is the dip on the pH in aquascape, ma'am.
Oh, based on the pH. Okay.
Yeah.
And Calvin, what about
Calvin? The Calvin is the small fish in the aquascape.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, Safira and Calvin, and also Studio
Mars. Thank you.
Okay. Chal, are you ready, Chal?
Ready, ma'am.
Okay, come on, Chal.
Wait. Mic saya kedengeran kan ya, ma'am?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Bentar, ma'am. Trouble dikit.
Okay. Yeah. It's your presentation, ya?
Yeah? Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Hello everyone. Today I want to presentate about silat. Pencak silat.
Okay, martial art ya, pencak silat.
Yes. Today I want to present about pencak silat and my name is Faisal Hidayat and Sen Pan from Social One. Okay, pencak silat. What is pencak silat? Pencak silat is one of native traditional martial arts Indonesia from Betawi. Mm-hmm. And pencak silat at that time functioned for self defense. But now pencak silat also as the art of beauty performance. And then silat is also often used for traditional Betawi weddings. As mm-hmm. Palang pintu, you know palang pintu, ya kan?
Yeah.
And last, then silat as well as one martial sport. Okay, next. Mm-hmm. In silat match are divided into two categories. They are art and fight. Mm-hmm. But for the category or fight of art has three groups such as single art, double, and team. Mm-hmm. And next. The organization of pencak silat in Indonesia is Pencak Silat Association of Indonesia or IPSI. There are so many organizations in IPSI such as Persaudaraan Sehati, Merpati Putih, Tapak Suci, and many others.
Mm-hmm.
And pencak silat usually using black costume like this and some identic property such as blangkon, arit, toya, and golok. And mm-hmm. the last one, pencak silat is one of the sports included in the Asian Games.
Mm.
Okay. Next. And this is the time to show beauty of pencak silat culture.
Mm-hmm.
Boleh ditayangin? Ya,
yeah, okay.
Kayak videonya.
Tapi aku nanya.
Udah. Tugasnya apa?
Ibu tuh membaca jaga jarak 3M, terus menghitung.
Oke. Okay. Ya. Yeah. Between Indonesia and Thailand, yeah.
Yeah.
Thailand win, ya.
Yeah. 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 In Asian Games.
Oh. Oh. But we win from Malaysia.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay, applause. Yeah. Question related to the topic.
Sharif, ma'am.
Okay, Sharif. The question is, Sharif.
Ical.
Oh.
But nowadays is, you know, many of the martial arts from the different country and effective for the modern self-defense. Mm-hmm. And why you still choose silat? Thank you.
Ulang-ulang tadi keputus, maaf.
There are so many type of martial arts,
like Muay Thai, boxing, and the others.
Yeah.
Why you choose silat?
Okay, because I'm very I'm from Betawi and I'm player very love martial art like pencak silat.
Okay. Oh yeah, so you are ingenious from Betawinese, yeah, from Jakarta. Okay.
Yeah, and I love Indonesia. Okay.
Okay, is there any other question? Jawad first, Jawad.
Okay. Ical.
Yes, Jawad.
Example are shown in Pancasila art.
Hah? Maaf. Sample?
What example are shown in Pancasila art? You say Pancasila in two categories.
Yes.
Right? Yes.
Saya praktek ini. Apa gimana?
Waduh.
What do you want, Jawad?
What are you doing in art pencaksilat?
Oh, art pencaksilat.
Art.
Oh.
In art pencaksilat tuh performance, uh-huh.
Performance. Okay, you perform. Yeah. You perform. Come on. Show Jawad the move.
Seriously, ma'am.
Yeah, come on. Art.
A little bit, yeah, ma'am.
Yeah.
Pakai books lagi. Kau sih lihat bawahnya ya, ma'am. Sempit banget kamar saya. Ya. Itu lah. Kayak. Like this.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you guys. Applause for all of you.
Melita, I wanna ask Ical, ma'am.
Oh, Melita. Melita. What question? I forgot.
It's okay, ma'am. Yeah. Ical, you said that pencak silat included in Asian Games. So my question is, when was silat competed in Asian Games for the first time?
Okay, pencak silat first time join in Asian Games from 2018. Jadi masih baru banget dia join di Asian
Games. Yeah. Okay, 2018 ya. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you guys. Applause once again.
Thank you,
next performance, please welcome Meg Green, what are you going to do?
To storytelling, ma'am.
Okay, you are going to tell a story. The story is?
Title is The Greedy Mouse.
The Greedy Mouse. Everybody listen, what is it? You find out what is the moral of the story. Come on, Meg Green, you can start from now on.
The greedy mouse saw a basket full of corn. He wanted to eat it, so he made a small hole in the basket. He squeezed in through the hole. He ate a lot of corn. He felt full, and he was very happy. Now he wanted to come out. He tried to come out through the small hole. He could not. His belly was full. He tried again, but it was of no use. The mouse started crying and rabbit was passing by. It heard the mouse cry and asked, "Why are you crying, my friend?" The mouse explained, "I made a small hole and came into the basket. Now I'm not able to get out through that hole." The rabbit said, "It is because you ate too much. Wait till your belly shrinks." The rabbit laughed and went away. The mouse fell asleep in the basket. Next morning, his belly had shrunk, but the mouse wanted to eat some corn. So he ate and ate. His belly was full once again. He thought, "Oh, now I will go out tomorrow The cat was the next passerby. He smelled the mouse in the basket. He lifted its lip. He ate the mouse. Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Okay, yeah. Guys, can you find out the moral of the story? The greedy mouse, very easy.
Arif,
jawab.
Ma'am.
Oh, Arif, sorry, Boris, sorry.
So, from the story, we can conclude the moral value is too much of greed is for yourself is harmful and not good.
Okay, thank you. Anyone? Is there any other opinion? The moral of the story? Anyone? Extra point? Okay, thank you, Syari. Thank you, McBreen. Applause.
Imam.
Oh, Yosa. What is it, Yosa?
So, the moral is don't be greedy.
Yeah, don't be greedy. Okay, applause once again. Okay, the next performance, please welcome Evander. Evander, what are you going to do?
Presentation, ma'am.
Okay, the topic is?
The topic is online education.
Online education, yeah, related to our situation now, yeah. Okay, everybody, yeah, you listen carefully, ask question based on the topic, online education. Come on, Evander.
Yeah, so thank you, ma'am. Good morning, Mamlin and friends.
Morning.
Today, I want to present a topic about online education. This is the table of contents for today's presentation.
Mm-hmm.
First, we're going to talk about what is education and what is online education. Second, we're going to talk about why we should consider online education as a way to run education and what are the benefits of online education.
Mm-hmm.
Third, online education versus traditional education. We're going to compare the advantages of online education over traditional learning. And the final thing is conclusion or the summary of the presentation. Before we begin, I have one quote from Nelson Mandela.
Mm-hmm.
One says, "Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world." Introduction. What is education in general? Education is nothing but gaining knowledge and skills which may use the past information, present, and also with future information transferred from one person or teacher to another through teaching, research, and or training. Now, our main focus is about online education. What is online education? Online education is electronically supported learning that relies on the internet for teacher or student interaction and the distribution of class material. From this simple definition comes an almost infinite number of ways to teach and learn outside of traditional classrooms and away from college campus. With online education, students can turn anywhere with internet access and electricity into a classroom. It can include audio, video, text, animations, virtual training environments, and live chats with professors or teachers. It's a rich learning environment with much more flexibility than a traditional classroom. The distance learning method is actually not a new thing. Earlier in the 19th century, commercial correspondence colleges were found where instructional missives would be distributed through postal service between students and professors. And in 1953, the University of Hauss made a history by offering first televised class on KUHT, or KUHT is a TV channel based in the United States, today called as Houston PBS. After television, the personal computer and internet were the next major inventions. to revolutionize distance education. And in 1989, the University of Phoenix became the first institution to launch a fully online collegiate institution. And why we should choose online education? There are at least 10 reasons why. First, it enhances students' technological skills, and it enhances Shakespeare speaking skills. It enables the students to communicate in ways they previously could not. And fourth, students are able to express their opinions and ideas freely. Next, it improves student independence. It also opens new range of possibilities, and it is also engaging for students as it involves audio and visual. It is appealing to students because of different learning styles, and it increases participation of students. And the last is, it's interactive and relevant. Over the period of time, online education has been widely accepted, with more and more parents trusting the quality of the system. At one point of time, online education was considered to be only for special students. But with the advancement of technology, parents across the globe have understood the advantages of online school. Let's take a look at this picture right here. At the top side, you can see the data of K-12 online schools. K-12 is an education management organization that provides online education designed as alternative to traditional education. It is based on the United States of America. Data shows a crazy amount of enrollments growth. In year 2000, only 5,000 were registered as students. Only 50,000, I mean. But in the year 2014, approximately 1 million were registered as students. That's only in America. In Indonesia, the growth in online education can also be seen with the emergence of online learning platforms such as Ruangguru, Genius, Quipper, and many more. Globally, in 2013 to 2014, there are approximately 3 million students that attended online school. In what ways online education is helpful? Online education has been receiving an overwhelming response from across the world. Most importantly, what really has convinced people to go for it is that because there is no hassle in pursuing education online. And moreover, the cost of online education is way too low than that of a traditional education. And similar to this, it also cuts down the transportation cost for those who don't come from well-privileged family. Also, another example of the online education's benefit is in an emergency situation like right now, such as during the current pandemic. Mm-hmm. Online learning method can be the only solution for education. Now we're gonna compare the online education between versus traditional education. The benefits of online education over regular education is, online education is easy. You can sit at home and gain knowledge. Regular education should be gained in particular place or center. Online education is less expensive. Regular education is a little bit more expensive due to transportation fee. And then next, online education. In online education, you can miss class and gain it anytime. But in regular education, if you miss the class, it's difficult to gain the missed class. Then next, in online education, there are no timings. In regular education, it should be done on the perfect time. And the final benefit is, in online education, you can get more experience in video or something like that. By the year 2012, 77% of academic leaders surveyed says that the students' outcome of online learning to be the same as traditional learning. Some also even says it is better or superior than traditional education, while 23% of them says that traditional learning is still the best method for education. So what is the conclusion? Hence, the two systems of education has got benefits and drawbacks. It cannot be told this particular system is best or worse. According to our convenience and educate, and based on the suitability of the benefits, we can choose wisely and educate ourselves better. So no matter what's the method, education is important, and there is no more hassle for gaining knowledge because learning knows no bounds. That's it for me. Thank you for listening.
Okay, guys. Question related to the topic.
Online. Hey, ma'am. Evelyn, ma'am. Evelyn, ma'am.
First, Najma.
So, in your opinion, what do you think about online education? Is it effective or not? And give the reasons why.
Okay. Is it effective or no? Yeah, Ivanda.
I will answer it first. So yes, it is effective based on what I just presented. It got many benefits, and also it seems like it's slightly better than regular mm-hmm. education due to simplicity and yeah. It's simple, it's relevant, and
okay,
it's much more efficient.
Okay, thank you. Evelyn, the question is?
Okay, based on your benefits that you talked before, what do you think if the online education still continues even though this pandemic is over?
Yeah.
Yes. Yes, for me, I think it's mm-hmm. can be considered mm-hmm. in the future, but maybe not for now, but in the future.
Yeah, well, I think because of the pandemic, the situation in our education is changed. Yeah, so in the future, yeah, the government will use both of them. Yeah, the blended between online and also offline education. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Dustin, how about you? What question?
According to your opinion, is there any negative impacts besides the whole positive impact that you explained before?
Is there any negative impact?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
There are also some disadvantages of online education as well.
Mm-hmm.
Because online learning don't have an instructor that can allow you to stay on task, so mm-hmm. you have to manage yourself to do your task properly without supervising or without supervising.
Okay.
Also, online course may create a sense of isolation because in online course you can meet other people face to face.
Mm-hmm. Okay, is there any other question? Yeah, Sela, this is Sela.
Founder, what do you think the online education can be more lazy than traditional education?
Okay.
Yes, there are actually potential that can also make students to be lazy because of the simplicity of it. Because mm-hmm. you don't have to go to school, you don't have to walk to school. You can just sit on your
mm-hmm.
house and just learn, so mm-hmm. it has potential.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Melati, the question is,
do you have any solution for a student that maybe their house have a low signal or net Wi-Fi network, it doesn't work good?
Maybe it's the job for our government to
To provide.
Yes, to provide students with less
It means the government should provide free internet, so the students around Indonesia will have better education. Okay, is there any other question? Okay, thank you guys. Applause for all of you. Welcome. Please welcome Farza. Farza, what are you going to do?
I'm going to present a PowerPoint.
Yeah, the topic is?
So the topic I broke for you today is a political practice in educational environment.
Wow.
So first, I'm going to explain to you the definition of political practice. So what is political practice? So basically, political practice is an act of influencing people to support certain political view or idea in order to gain a lot of mass. This action is completely legal and even protected in our constitution, as long as it's running in the right time and in the right place. However, if it's running without any responsibility, it can bring a lot of negative impact. So next, there are three stages I classified, but there are three stages of political practice. First is influencing. So in this first phase or the first stage, usually the suspect or the person who commit the political practice will begin with setting his plan. The plan is usually contain a question like what, when, where, and to whom. So after setting his plan complete, the suspect or the person who commit the political practice begin to convincing or influencing other people to supporting his political view. And then after he's complete the first stage, it comes to the next stage is provoking. So in this stage, provoking is the person or the suspect of this political practice will begin to insulting, harassing, even mocking his political opponent. So it will give the opponent a negative sentiment towards the people by provoking the political opponents. And then the last stage is urging. So urging is the stage where the suspect will begin to forcing his will, his political idea to other people, and even judging other people that don't have the same political idea as him. So that is the stage of political practice. And then source that I'm going to talk in here is the source in educational environment. The source can come from teacher first. Teacher is the highest potential person that can spread this political practice, because teacher is a role model, a figure for their students, so they can easily convince their student to to supporting their political idea by influencing them in the middle of learning, because they are a role model or figure for their student. And then the second source that can be the person that spread the political practice in educational environment is senior. Senior is as impactful as teacher because they are a role model and figure as well for their junior. So their influence can also influence in their junior to have the same political view as him. And then the third one is school staff. Even though school staff is not as significant as teacher or senior, but they can also be they have the same potential to spread this political practice amongst the school folks. They can potentially spreading this to student, even though as not as potential as teacher or senior. And then the last but not least is curriculum system. If curriculum system is a perfect media to spread a political practice or political agenda, this curriculum system can even bring a political practice to a larger scale that can even make a propaganda. So the curriculum system is the most dangerous and the biggest threat, because it can affect the whole educational system itself. So that is for the source of the political practice in educational environment. And then the impact is first there are marginalization. So marginalization is it differentiate people based on the group they are supporting. So it can separate not person with another person. So it will make another impact such as disintegration. And then because of disintegration, there will be no harmony inside the educational environment. And because there's no harmony, there will be conflict. And then the other impact of this political practice in educational environment is political bias. Also, political bias is a subjective point of view towards some political group or political idea. And then the last is how to prevent the political practice, especially in environmental idea. So mainly there are four ways how to prevent this political practice in educational environment. First is encourage political awareness, and then second is keep political practice as far from the educational system. And then the third one is be objective. The one who needs to be objective in this occasion is not just the teacher, but also the education system itself. It needs to be objective. It's not siding some of a political group or political power. And then the last is open with any difference. That's it, man.
Hey, guys, any question related to the topic?
Me.
Yeah, Yosa, what is it?
Oh, Farza, what is example of cases you can provide to us about this the topic do you presenting?
Can you repeat it again?
Repeat once again.
So some of cases that you that some of cases that can you provide to us about your topic you explaining today?
Oh,
example.
Yes.
So the example is political practice is usually become it's much bigger when there are like presidential vote. So the example is like a teacher influencing the student, their student to support things from for example I'm a teacher and then I'm convincing my student in 2019 election for them to supporting Jokowi or supporting Prabowo. That's the real example of political practice in educational environment.
Okay. Yeah.
Thank you.
Is it clear? Okay. The other, is there any other question?
But I have a question.
Yeah, Ali, what is it?
How we stop this practice from happening?
Repeat.
How do we stop this practice from happening again?
How do we stop this kind of action from happening?
Just like I said in my presentation before, there are mainly four, but it's not limited to that. But yeah, but mainly we need to increase our political education. Mm-hmm. And then we also need to open to any different, because we are living in a diverse country. We're living in a diverse world, so we need to also open to any change and then any opinion that it's not as that it's not like our political view. So yeah, just like my presentation, there are more, and yeah, encourage political awareness, keep it away from educational system, and then also be objective. Be objective. Objective if, is really important.
Mm-hmm.
In order to prevent any political bias.
Okay,
thank you, Fazer.
Okay, is there any other question, guys? Okay, thank you, Alif, Yosa, and Farza. Applause for all of them. Okay, guys, this is the end of our lesson. Don't forget to submit, upload your PowerPoint, your speech, yeah, your story to the Google Classroom. Next week, we are going to discuss for the new topic, yeah? Okay, this is the end of our lesson. See you next week. Have a nice weekend. Bye-bye. You can leave the class. Salam.